कृष्णं सांगोपांगास्त्रपार्षदं यज्ञैः संकीर्तनप्रायैर्यजन्तिः सुमेधसः अन्तः कृष्णं बहिर्गौरं दर्शिताङ्गादिवैभवं कलौ संकीर्तनाद्यै स्मः कृष्णचैतन्यमाश्रिता जयतां मथुरा भूमौ श्रीलरूपसनातनौ यौ विलेकयतस्तत्त्वं ज्ञापकौ पुस्तिकामिमां कोऽपि तद्बान्धवो भट्टो दक्षिणद्विजवंशजः विविच्य वेलिकद्ग्रन्थं लिखिताद्वृद्धवैष्णवैः तस्याद्यं ग्रन्थनालेकं क्रान्तव्युत्क्रान्तखण्डितं पर्यालोच्याथ पर्यायं कृत्वा लिखति जीवकः यः श्रीकृष्णपादाम्भोजा भजनैकाभिलाषवान् तेनैव दृश्यतामेतद् अन्यस्मै शपथोऽर्पितः श्रीमद्भागवतं श्रीमन्मन्त्रदेशिकमिं श्रीमद्भागवतार्थानां सन्दर्भं कर्तुमाश्रये अथ नत्वा मन्त्रगुरून् गुरून् भागवतार्थदान् श्रीभागवतसन्दर्भं सन्दर्भं वश्मि लेखितुम् यस्य ब्रह्मेति संज्ञां क्वचिदपि निगमे याति चिन्मात्रसत्ता प्यंसो यस्यांशकैस्वैर्विभवति वशयन्नेव मायां पुमांस एकं यस्यैव रूपं विलसति परमव्योम्नि नारायणाख्यम् स श्रीकृष्णो विधत्तां स्वयमिह भगवान् प्रेम तत्पादभाजाम् हरे कृष्ण पुराणा आर नोन एज पुराणा वाई पूर्णात् पुराणम सो या इट कंप्लीट्स व्हाट meaning of the Vedas. It completes the meaning of the Vedas. So that's why it is known as Puranam. That means we have similarities with the Vedas, not in the point of authenticity. Anyway, Vedas are authentic only. But another problem we have with the Vedas, they are not fully available, and also they demands high intelligence to get the meanings of those because of the complexities there in that language. It is using so many notations. That means every swara is also 18 types. So that consider that takes that kind of 18 types of swaras. For each swara, there are 18 types are used in the Vedas, and finding the that kind of meanings. Finding the meanings of that kind of words is not so easy for this Kali Yuga people. This is one problem, and another is Vedas also, the meanings of the Vedas are determined by some sages according to their understanding. So, but there is also, one may say, that means already six sages are there. They gave the conclusions of the Vedas. So anyway, if you don't have Veda, so you can take any one of these. But what is the problem? They are not all not in the similar line actually. They are not concluding into one meaning. So there are the different meanings they are having. So that's why that option is also ruled out. We cannot take any one of that. That means six are there. Vedavyas also is there. But directly we cannot say, I'm taking Vedavyas. If you want to take Vedavyas, then you have to show the reason also. So that's why that approach is we kept for time being side. And then what is another so problem with the Vedas? Dushparatvat. Next. Duradigama ardhatvat. So the meaning of Veda is also very difficult actually. To extract the meaning from that is not so easy. So because of these reasons, so we are going to the, instead of Vedas, that means that non-defective Shabda, instead of Vedas, we are taking the Itihasas and Puranas. Okay. Itihasas and Puranas, they are fully available. And Itihasa and Purana, they can complete the meanings of the Vedas, because in the Mahabharata it is said that Itihasa Purana Abhyam Vedam Samupabrahmayet. So this is a Pramana we have from the Mahabharata. And also the word derivation, if you see Puranam word, it is derived Puranat Puranam. Since it is completing something, that's why it is known as Puranam. So it is completing the Vedas. Then if it wants to complete Vedas, it should be Veda. So Purana should be Veda. Otherwise, it cannot do that work. The reason is we know any golden bangle is there, and if it is not filled completely, so to fill that, you need gold only, not the lead or something. Iron you cannot use. So it's incompatible actually. It's not compatible, no? That's why. If you want to fill, then you need compatible thing. So like even the, for the charger and this, your laptop, compatibility is necessary. So incompatible things you cannot use to fill. So now, then after that, we saw this. Now we have to determine this, the position of the Puranas, where they are. They are Vedas or the outside the Vedas. That is a point. So we have four Vedas. So these four in Itihasa and Puranas are also inside of that four Vedas or outside. That is a question Purupakshi is asking. What do you say? It is inside the four Vedas. We have Rig Veda, Yajur, Sama, Atharva. In these four Vedas, inside it is there. Then if it is said inside, then that is Veda only. Why you are saying it as a Purana? So then what is a Purana? You show me. That is Veda, na? It is inside the Veda, means it's a Veda. It's not Purana. Then show me the Purana. Then they are not inside the four Vedas. They are separate outside. Then they are not Vedas. Puranas are not Vedas. Then how can you use Puranas to fill the, complete the Vedas? You cannot use. Like this, Purupakshi raised the objection. Then after that, Siddhanti, what he is saying? No, it is not. It's not inside of the four Vedas, it is outside, but it is Veda. That means it is different from the four Vedas, but it is Veda. It is different from the four Vedas. That's why Bheda is there, and also it is Veda. So that's why similarity is also there. Bheda. So previously, Shankaracharya, what he was thinking? He was thinking that he was writing the Madhyandana Sruti. That's anyway coming today, actually. That is next point is that only. So on this Shruti, he was commenting that these Vedas and Puranas, Puranas and Itihasas are also, they are not strictly, they are inside the Vedas only. Like that he commented like that. So now Jiva Goswami is defeating that. So he didn't mention that kind of, that means inside the four Vedas only, Purana and Itihasa, this conception is anyway he is showing in the next Anucheda, so he is rejected. The Nirastam, like that he is going to tell. That means now whatever we have Srimad Bhagavatam, these are all, that means according to Shankaracharya, they are all not Purana Itihasa. That is a point actually. That is his perception. After that, so Purana Itihasas are having the similarity, Bheda, Abheda, and also Bheda. How Purana Itihasas are similar to the Vedas? In what respect they are similar? Apaurishayatvam. The origin is same. And next, they are having the difference because Swarabheda. So Swarabheda is there. That means we are using the different Swaras, Udatta, Anudatta, Swarita. This Bheda is there in the Veda, four Vedas, but it is not there in the Purana Itihasas. That's why Bheda is also there. Like this, Bheda, Bheda, Sambandha is established. Next, Rugadi Bihi Samam Anayoho Apaurusheyatvena Abhedo Madhyandana Srutau Madhyandina Srutau Eva Vyajyate Evam va aresya mahato bhutasya nisvatitam nisvasitametat yad rugvedo yajurveda samavedo tharvangirasa itihasa puranam ityadina. Where is the point in this? Search. Not here. Six now. Okay. You people are helping me to my material too. Good. Because these letters all look like same. For me. After this one. See na? Okay. Yes. Okay, Itihasa Puranas are equal to Rig and other Vedas since both have non-human origin as indicated in the Madhyandana Shruti. So what the Shruti is saying, evam va are asya maho mahato bhutasya nisvasitam yetad yad rugvedaha yajurvedaha samavedaha atharvana angirasa ittahasa purana. That means all the Vedas and Puranas, Itihasas, all are exhaled by the Lord. The breathing.
Breathing, you know? So this coming from Karuna Daksai Vishnu.
This Vedas.
Yeah.
Vedas are coming from which Vishnu you are saying? Yeah, it's coming from the Karnano Sai Vishnu.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But Brahmaji, then here it is, photo is there, na? Brahmaji is hearing through Krishna's flute. Like that, something.
No.
Krishna is playing the flutes and all swaras and Vedas coming out. Not like that.
Narayanad Udbhutoyam Varanakramaha. You learned or not this? That first sutra in the Sanskrit. Oh, you are not attending classes? That means you are attending, na? First day he explained or not? Narayana Udbhutaya. I asked him to explain this. Yeah, all the varnas are coming from the Narayana. Panini says means from the Shiva's Damaru. This Ayun Rilri Kevangaya Uchi. These are all coming. These Pratyahara Sutras 14. So they are coming from the Shivaji's Damaru. So, but he didn't say they are generated from the Damaru. They are coming means maybe from other place they came and they stayed there. We don't know. So, from the breathing of the Narayan, all these Vedas came, and also along with the Rig, Yajus, Itihasas and Puranas also came out. So that's why all are Apaurushaya. So this is the, this sloka is the, or sorry, this Rigveda mantra is a proof to say these Itihasas and Puranas are also Apaurushaya. So this is establishing the origin is same. That means Abheda. Okay. Anyway, Bheda is very much known to all of you because everyone knows Itihasa Puranas and the Vedas, they have the Swara Bheda. That's why it's not needed, any proof is not needed for that. That's a known fact actually. Everyone knows. Okay, like this. We'll go to the next Anusheda. Otherwise, everyone should have one mic, small mic. It will be nice. Huh? Instead of searching for mic all the time.
Huh. In the previous Anusheda, bro, the notes are there that B, B sixth B. In that, there is other sampradayas take that the order of Varnas and Puranas can vary from Kalpa to Kalpa.
That's a Krama. Actually, Swarabheda I explained. And Krama, sometimes they say that these Varnas are changing. So the Krama of the order of the Varnas are changing. So someone, after that, something is coming.
Kalpa to Kalpa, it vary, bro.
I like that someone accept, but we are that means what is written? They are not agreeing. So this point is has to be researched. That's why star is. That means this fully, it is not thoroughly established point. It's not thoroughly established. It is out of the even text also. It is not there in the text. Just for our reference, it is written. While writing the, compiling the book, then we'll expand on this. That's why, as a note, I kept myself.
Apurusha, because it's a history, na? They changes or in different times, and Vedvyas have written.
Puranas are Apurusha only. Purana and Itihasas are Apurusha because they are all coming from the breathing, exhaling of the Narayana. So that is a Madhyanjana Sruti. Sruti Pramana is highest. Sruti is saying means, or yeah. So even Bhagavatam also is saying, if you see in the Bhagavatam third canto, in the 12th chapter, so you'll be seeing the, all the Vedas are coming from the various mouths, and also Puranas, Itihasas are also coming. And we'll be seeing that also reference. So these are already existing, Puranas, Itihasas, not only Vedas, Puranas, Itihasas are also all are existing. But just what? Whenever, that means they are disappearing. So Rishis, they do that tapasya and they will be reappearing to them and they will be propagating that once again. So it keeps on happening. So Vedvyasa also is doing this, just he's dividing. It is already there. It is Vyasaha. Meaning of Vyasaha means the one who divides. So he's only just divide. He is not writing anything extra or own. Next, Ateva Skanda Prabhasa Khande. Pura tapascha charogram amaranam pitamaha avirbhutastato veda shadanga padakramaha ततः पुराणमखिलं सर्वशास्त्रमयं ध्रुवं नित्यशब्दमयं पुण्यं शतकोटिप्रविस्तरं निर्गतं ब्रह्मणो वक्त्रा तस्य वेदानि बोधता ब्राह्म्यं पुराणं प्रथमं इत्यादि। This is clear, nice, it's direct, simple Sanskrit. Okay, okay. Pura tapaha chacharaha ugram amaranam pitamahaha. So who did the tapasya? Grandfather of the devatas, Brahmaji, performed the tapasya. So then, avirbhutaha tataha vedaha. From him, all the Vedas appeared. Along with the Shadanga, Padakrama, along with the all the Vedangas, six Sanghas, with their verses in particular order. Then, Tataha Puranam Akhilam Sarvasastra Mayam Dhruvam Nitya Shabda Mayam Punyam Satakoti Pravistharam. Vedas came, Vedangas came, and next what came? Puranam Akhilam, total Puranam. Is one Purana only, total one, and that came. And how much it is weight? What is the weight of that? Is having the Satakoti Pravistaram, 100 crores. 100 crores weight it is. Slokas are there, verses. Nitya Shabdamayam Punyam. It is what? Nitya Shabdamayam. It is eternal. This Purana is also eternal. Satakoti Pravistaram. Puranas total, how many verses are there? Satakoti. 100 crores means 1 billion. 1 billion verses are there. Then, Nirgatam Brahmano Vaktra Tasya Vedat Nibhoda. Nibhoda. Prabhu, Mike, you have to, every time reminding Mike, what is this actually, Prabhu?
Hare Krishna. So, Purana came...
Before, one request for the answer students, whenever you want to find the mic, get it, then you start. If spontaneously if you start, so information is missing for the answer student, online students. Yeah.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Yes, yeah.
So, Purana came in this like a... breathing of the Lord, and 100 crores verses are there. So we see Skanda Puran, Vishnu Puran, Garud Puran, different Puranas are there. Then in beginning it was only one Puran, or like that already different Puranas were there.
So it is a total one Purana only, Akhilam Puranam, one Purana only.
Then it divided, yes, later on.
Even Vedas also one Veda only.
Okay, okay.
It is divided later.
Thank you. Yeah.
So emerged from Brahma's mouth. Please hear about different Puranas starting with Brahma Purana and others. So Brahmana Vaktra Veda Veda Nibhodata Bahyam Brahmyam Puranam Pratamam. So now we start here each Purana. Okay, we'll discuss each Purana. First we'll start with the Brahma Purana. अत्र शतकोटि संख्या ब्रह्मलोके प्रसिद्धा इति तथा उक्तम तृतीय स्कंधे च सॉरी इट यू हैव टू स्टॉप हियर अत्र शतकोटि संख्या ब्रह्मलोके प्रसिद्धा तथा उक्तम सो 100 क्रोर्स ऑफ पुराण वेयर इट इज श्यामानंद प्रभु इट इज इन द ब्रह्मलोक इट इज इन ब्रह्मलोक सो 100 क्रोर्स बिग वॉल्यूम And ours is modified, condensed. So, Tritiya Skandhecha, in the third canto also we are seeing. Rugyajussama atharvakyan Vedan Purvadi Bhirmukhaihi. So, okay. The Rig Yajus, some other Vedas emanated from the eastern mouth. It is easy. Okay. If you want 3, 12, 37. Maybe 1, 3, 4 classes you will not be having Purupakshi. It's like just information it will go on. Then after that Purupakshi will come. So now you have to, you can take rest. No Purupakshi, nothing. Without Purupakshi, always will become, that means tomorrow's actually class will be. Maitreyuvacha rugyajusama atharvakyan vedan purvadhi bhirmukhaihi shastramijyam stutistomam prayas chittam vyadhakrama. Translation, Maitreya said, beginning from the front face of the Brahma, gradually the four Vedas, Rig, Yajus, Sama and Atharva became manifest. Thereafter, Vedic hymens, which had not been pronounced before, priestly rituals, the subject matters of the recitation and transcendental activities were all established, one after another. Ityadi Prakarane. Next, Itihasa Puranani Panchamam Vedamishwarah Sarvebhya Eva Vaktrebhyah Sasruje Sarva Darshanah. After that, so next what came, just if you see in between what is there. So that is that Ayurvedam Dhanurvedam Gandharvam Vedamatmanah Stapatyam Chasrujatvedam Kramat Purvadi Bhirmukaihi. That means that is a 37th sloka. In our BBT it is 38. So he also created the medical science, military art, musical art and architectural science from all from the Vedas. They all emanated one after another, beginning from the front face. Next, Itihasa Puranani Panchamam Vedamishwarah Sarvebhya Eva Vaktrebhyah Sasruje Sarva Darshanah. Then he created the fifth Veda, the Puranas and histories from all his mouths, since he could see all the past and present and future. Sasruje Sarva Darshanah. So here what he said, Ityadi Prakarane, if you come to the Mula. Atra, Apicha Atra Sakshad Veda Sabdaha Prayuktaha Purana Itihasa Yoho. Now Jiva Goswami is saying that this Itihasa and Purana are directly said as here, Panchamam Vedam. Anyatracha, in another place also. Puranam Panchamo Veda. Puranam Panchamo Veda. Itihasaha Puranam Cha Panchamo Veda Uchyate. So, Vedanadhyapayamasa Mahabharatam Mahabharata Panchaman Ityado. Anyatra, it is some different place, okay. Anyatha, Vedan ityadau api panchamatvam na avakalpate. Samana jatiya niveshitatvat sankhyayah. Now the point is, now itihasa and puranas are known as panchama veda. Why? If they are not Veda, can anyone say it as a Panchama Veda? Like you see, now you have the two markers. So we are counting 1, 2. So can you say this is 3? No, you cannot say it is 3 because Jati is not equal. So when there is a Samana Jati, then only you will be counting them as progressively. Progressively you can continue. Otherwise, you will say 1, 2, two markers, one duster, like that we say. It's not that the, so three markers are there or three dusters are there, you cannot say. So that means here, Itihasa Puranas are counted as Panchama Veda because they are also same category. That means Vedatvam is there in the Purana and Itihasa also. That's why. In the Bhavish, if Purana and Itihasas are not Vedas, then they may not be considered as the fifth because continuous counting is done among the objects that belong to the same category. Okay. Next. Bhavishya Purane. So, Karshnam cha panchamam vedam yan mahabharatam smritam. So, Mahabharata of the Krishna Dvaipayana Vyasa is considered the fifth Veda. It is also said in the Bhavishya Purana. Mahabharata is known as fifth Veda. Tathacha Sama Kaumuthiya Shakhayam. In the same way, in the Chandogya Upanishad, Kaumuthiya Shakha, the Sama of Samveda, is said. And of Chandogya Upanishad, so it is said that Rigvedam Bhagavo Dhyemi Yajurve. Rigvedam Bhagavo Dhyemi Yajurvedam Samavedam Atharvanam Chaturdham Itihasam Puranam Panchamam Vedanam Vedam. Till now we discussed the Panchamatvam of the Itihasa Puranas. We proved from the different Puranas. Now we are showing from the Vedas also. From the Chandogya Upanishad, we are saying that what this way, Panchamam Puranam. This is, that means I have studied the Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda, Atharva Veda, the fourth, the Itihasa and Puranas, the fifth Veda among the Vedas. It is from the Shruti Pramanam. Ateva asya mahato bhutasya ityadau itihasa purana yoscha itihasa purana yoho chaturnameva antar bhutatva kalpanaya prasiddha pratyakyan nirastam. Yes. Hare Krishna Maharaj.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. So from these several quotes, including Chandogya,
yes,
we see that Itihasa Purana is considered Panchama Veda. Shankaracharya,
yeah,
does not accept this.
Yes. Shankaracharya's opinion is, that means he commented just this. This line is saying, now, Atayeva asya mahato bhutasya ityadau itihasa purana yoho chaturnameva antarbhutatvam. That means, considering the itihasa purana inside to the four Vedas. This way, commented. Who commented? Shankaracharya. That is nirastam. That means, that is defeated now. This line.
Okay, so, but he accepts it as fifth Veda. Is that right?
Maharaj?
Shankaracharya accepts Chandogya Upanishad.
Yes.
So that means he accepts Itihasa Purana as fifth Veda. Is that right?
Actually, Shankaracharya, what he did, so Chandogya Upanishad is saying Atma Vare Asya Mahato Bhutasya Nishvasitam Etad Rugveda Yajurveda Samaveda Atharva Angirasa Itihasa Purana. So this is a Chandogya Upanishad statement. So in this Chandogya Upanishad statement we are saying, so Lord exhaled, so first Rugveda, next Yajur, Sama, Atharva, after that Itihasa and Purana. So he is saying that Shankaracharya commented on this line. So this is a Chandogya Upanishad statement, Madhyandana Shruti. So Chandogya Upanishad. So commented in his commentary that these Itihasa and Puranas are inside to the four Vedas only, not separate. That is his commentary actually. If we see his commentary on this Chandogya Upanishad statement, so what is his commentary? He is considering Itihasa Purana not separately, but those are all, these Itihasa Puranas are inside to the four Vedas only. So that way he commented. Now Jiva Goswami is saying that no, these two Itihasa Puranas are not inside to the four Vedas, but they are fifth Veda, separately only. It is a separate fifth Veda. Yeah. It's okay, mother. Close, open Karuna.
So this means that Shankara is accepting Itihasa Purana as Veda, whether as part of four Veda or as fifth, he's accepting as
Itihasa Purana he's accepting, but he's not accepting whatever Itihasa Purana we have now. Because he doesn't want to consider these as Itihasa Puranas. So he is considering those already there in the four Vedas only.
I see, okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So actually, what is happening? So Madhyandana Shruti. So according to this Shruti, what is this Shruti actually? Atma. Atma vare sya mahato bhutasya. This statement is there, na? So what is this statement is saying? So Lord exhaled Pura Rug Yajus Sama Adharvangirasa Purana Ithyasa. These are all exhaled from by the Lord. Okay. So this is a general, that means understanding of the general meaning of this mantra. Now on this Shankaracharya, what he commented, he is saying that this Itihasa and Purana, these two, so he is saying that there are four Vedas, these are the four Vedas, they are inside to this only. That means Itihasa Puranas, he is not accepting whatever we have separately. Itihasa Puranas. Those, according to him, those are not Itihasa Puranas. Those already in the four Vedas only. So they are in the four Vedas only. That in that way he commented on this. If you see the Shankaracharya commentary on this Chandogya Upanishad Madhyandana Shruti statement, you'll be seeing like that. Now this Prakhyatam, what Jiva Goswami is saying that, so here Itihasa Purana Yoho Chaturnam Eva Antarbhutatvam. Chaturnam Eva Antarbhutatvam. Itihasa Purana Yoho Chaturnam Eva Antarbhutatvam means they are inside to the four Vedas only. They are not separate. In this way, Chatur Antarbhutatva Kalpanaya Prasiddha Pratyakhyanam. This is a very famous commentary. That means Shankaracharya's commentary it is. Name is not given. So Jiva Goswami didn't mention the name, but this is the Shankaracharya's commentary. So Shankaracharya said like that. The Itihasa Puranas are not separately are there. They are inside in the Vedas itself. So that means he is rejecting the present available Itihasas and Puranas. That's why he didn't touch those. Only that means he asks that any reference means it should be from the Shruti, Vedas. He didn't touch. It's not Pramana. That is his stand actually. Now Jiva Goswami, what he is saying, no, Itihasa Puranas are not inside these four Vedas. They are separately existing. Four Vedas are four Vedas, and Itihas Puranas are the fifth Veda. Fifth Veda. He is saying, Jiva Goswami's stand this is. And Jiva Goswami is proving this. So these you can see from the one he said from the Upanishad also. What he said? Rugvedam Bhagavodhyemi Yajurvedam Samavedam Atharvanam Chaturdham Itihasam Puranam Panchamam Puranam Panchamam. It is also from the Chandogya Upanishad. Here clearly said Puranam Panchamam. Yes, Maharaj.
So I guess my question is, how can Shankara ignore this statement from Chandogya Upanishad, which is very explicitly saying that
Panchamam this. Yeah. So then they will say, they will say that this is your Shruti Vakyam. That means you manufacture. This we don't consider. So like
but
the Madhvacharya is also quoting several Shruti Vakyas, and which are not accepted by the Advaitins.
So he's saying this is not authentic Chandogya.
That is the second option they will be immediately bring out. But actually, what is the what they commented on this same Chandogya Upanishad? I'm not knowing exactly. But general, you can see in the another cases. So Madhvacharya was quoting so many Upanishad statements and Shruti statements in the various Brahma Sutras, which are not at all accepted by the Advaitins. They say that these are all speculated by the Madhvacharya only. He manufactured this to prove his philosophy. So like this. So there is always a rival is there. This kind of fighting is there. But Jiva Goswami says that I am following the Vruddha Vaishnavas. So for my reference, Ramanuja and Madhva, they are my authentic sources. Even if I don't find in the original book, that means that quote, but if it is there in the Madhvacharya, if he quoted somewhere, then I will take only. I will take that. And like this, in coming next Anuchedas, he will be saying like that. So, because Madhvacharya and Vyasatirtha, Jayatirtha, all these, so he is, Jiva Goswami is saying that I am following all of them. They are Vaishnavas because they are all approved by the Bhagavatam itself. So this Dakshina, in the Bhagavatam, there is a sloka is there. No? So in the South India, so various Vaishnavas, Sri Vaishnavas. So he's accepting. This is the proof. So they are the Vaishnavas. Like this, he'll be, in the future discussions, it will be coming. Okay. The prasiddham pratyakhyanam nirastam. So now finally Jiva Goswami, what he established, Purana and Itihasas are the Panchama Veda. So whatever the prasiddha vyakhyanam, the famous commentary, that is Shankaracharya's commentary, nirastam, it is defeated. No, we should not. Because he didn't take name Jiva Goswami also. So, no. Because there is some reason behind this. Just why Shankara? To bewilder. So you will be seeing in another Purana, Shankaracharya is by following the statement of, that means by following the order of Vishnu. So to bewilder these, whoever not believing in the Lord and very much based upon the crooked logic. So to bewilder them, to send them to the hellish planets. So Shankaracharya is coming, is following the orders of the Vishnu. Shiva, in the form of Shankara, he is going to coming and he is bewildering all of them. So like that. But here, Jiva Goswami also appreciates in the one place. Even Shankaracharya also is finally concluding in his Bhaja Govindam. So he is also appreciating, he is glorifying the Krishna only. So of course, he is not directly speaking about that, but in his works, he mentioned like that. So Jiva Goswami says in the future. commentaries, future text. That's why in the society, because you to bewilder them, you have to separate the Itihasa Puranas. Because Itihasa Puranas very boldly, directly telling about the truth. And but you cannot twist the Itihasa Purana statements because they are written in very simple language and they are very easy also. Any common man can understand. So that's why if you want to bewilder them, so what you have to take? You should not take this and take this such a high complex text and give the your own meanings. That is easy actually. So if you have complex text, it is easy to make the confuse the people. You can make the your own derived meanings for that. But if in the Itihasas, Puranas, directly Krishna is a supreme personality. Krishna's the Bhagavan Swayam. What is the problem? Directly it is said. So in that case, so it is difficult to interpret that in the secondary way. So that's a better what? To bewilder them, let us fully Itihas Puranas take out completely authenticity of Itihas Puranas reject. So like this. So I think actually it's my speculation. It's my Kapola Kalvitam. So maybe Shankaracharya did because of this only he rejected the Itihasa Puranas. This is my Kapola Kalvitam. But next. Now we are going to once again substantiate the panchamatvam of the Puranas again. What is that? Next Anusheda. Next Anusheda means even Anusheda numbering is also different in the different texts, in the different sources actually. So next after that, I don't say it is Anusheda, but it is text we continue. Panchamatve Karanam cha vayu purane sutavakyam. Now sutavakyam. Following me. Itihasa purana nam vaktaram samyagevahi mam chaiva pratijagraha bhagavan ishwarah prabhu चतुर्धाव्यकल्पयेत्चातुर्होत्रम् अभूतस्मिन् तेन यज्ञमकल्पयेत् आध्वर्यम् यजुभिस्तु ऋग्भिर्होत्रम् तथैव च औद्गात्रम् सामभिश्चैव ब्रह्मत्वम् चाप्यथर्वभिः आख्यानैश्चाप्युका उपाख्यानैर्गाथाभिर्द्विज सत्तमा पुराणसंहितांश्चक्रे पुराणार्थविशारदः यच्छिष्टं तु यजुर्वेद इति शास्त्रार्थनिर्णयः इति ओके व्हाट It is there in your material, no? Is there? Yeah. Many are not reading with me. That's why I'm thinking it's not there. Are we? In this book? In this book, 36. What is the translation of this? First, Itihasa Purananam Vaktaram Samyagyevahi Mamcha Eva Pratijagraha Bhagavan Ishwaraha Prabhu. The Supreme Lord, Vedavyas accepted me only as the speaker of the Itihasas and Puranas. So who is saying like this? Suta Goswami is saying. He selected Suta as speaker of the Itihasa Purana. What? Eka Asit Yajur Vedaha. Initially, only one Veda was there. Its name was Yajurveda. There was one Veda called Yajurveda. Next, chaturdha vikalpayet, then it is divided into four. So it's divided into four means it is not divided. Four vikalpayet means four are taken out actually. From that, four are taken out. Vyabhajati is not said. Vakalpayat is said. That means four are arranged from that. This word we should have put this some attention. If you say four, he divided four, then we don't have any space. Then we will be saying that Itihasa Purana Sar also is inside the four Vedas. That will come. So this word is a key word actually. What is there? Initially, one Veda. What is the name of the Veda? Yajurveda. What Vyasadeva did? He arranged four. Vakalpayat, not Vyabhajat. It is divided into four. Is it like that? No. He arranged four. On what basis? If you take out four from this, there should be some principle or not. On what basis these categories are made? On what basis he took? What rule? So chaturdha vikalpayat chaturhotram abhutasmin tena yagnam kalpayat. So in this, by using this four, what happened? Chaturhotram abhavat. Chaturhotram abhavat means these four became the chaturhotram. The four became the four chaturhotram. And by this that means yagna is arranged. Next, advaryam yajubihi rugbir hotram tathaiva cha audgatram samabhischaiva brahmatvam chapya dharvabihi. This is what? This is advaryam. This is advaryam. This is hotram. This is audghatam. Audghatram. Okay. Audghatram. Then total four together. Altogether four known as chaturhotram. Advaryam hotram tram brahmatvam of all these, what? First of all, tell me, what are these? Four types of agyas. Anyone have any other ideas? Your
four type of activities related four, to yagya.
Four type of the karma.
Karma.
These are the karma. This is also karma. This is also karma. Four are the karma. And this is karma. And total, this is also chaturhotram is what? Karma. Karma means yagya. Yagya. Yagna, you can be, he's having several meanings. Yagna means karma. prescribed duty. Nitya karma, naimittik karma. This is naimittik karma. Sacrifice. So, advaryam karma is there. This karma, to do this karma, you need what? Mantras you need. What mantras you use for the doing the advaryam karma? Yajubihi. Yaju mantras. Yajubihi means, so mantras, yaju mantras. And hotra means, what mantras you use? Avadghatram karma you do with what mantras? Sama. And the Brahma? Atharva. Atharva? Mantras. Yeah. That means here, all these mantras are there. What mantras are there? Mantras related to the karma advaryam are there. Mantras related to the hotram are also there. Mantras related to the karma audgatram are also there. Mantras related to the karma brahmatvam. Okay? Are there. All these mantras are used in the various karmas, are existing in which? What is this? Yajurveda. Okay? Yajurveda, this. It is having all these mantras. Now, so based upon the activity, you took out those mantras and formed as a set. And this set of mantras are useful for the advaryam karma, like that hotram, audgatram, brahmatram. And all together, four karmas together are known as chatur hotram. So that means, chatur hotram means, by having the chatur hotram, you can perform the yajna. That means to perform the yajna, this is what yajna kunda. Four ritviks are there. Yes. Who is he? He is Hota. Hotra karma. What he does? Hota will do the Hotram karma. Okay. Now he recite the mantras. Which mantras? Hota will recite the mantras which are related to the Hotram karma. That means which mantras those are all? Rik. Confusing, bro. Hotram is what? Hotram and Hota different. Hotram is, that's why I'm saying very slowly. So Hotram is, what I said Hotram means? Huh? Karma. Advaryam is karma. Yes, sir. Karma, 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 karma. So these are all the karma. To do this karma, what you need? Mantras. And these mantras are chanted by whom? Hota. That means Hotram karma. Mantras related to the Hotram karma are chanted by the Hota. Similarly, mantras related to the Advaryam karma so are chanted by whom? Advaryuhu. Advaryuhu. Karma is known as Advaryam. Advaryu do the karma. What is that? Advaryam. Difference is there or not? Advaryuhu, Advaryam. The karma related to the Advaryuhu is known as Advaryam. Tadyat Pratyaya. If you apply, then you'll get that. Next, the mantras related to the Audgatram karma are chanted by whom? Udgata. Udgata. So these mantras are what? These are the Samaveda mantras. These mantras are Yajur. This is Rik. These mantras. And who is remaining? Brahma. Brahmatvam karma. So mantras related to the Brahmatvam karma are chanted by Brahma, not Brahmana. Yes. Brahma. So this mantras are known as Adharvana Veda. Adharva Veda. Adharva. Clear, this is philosophy. That means all the mantras are here. Based upon this specific activity, mantras are took out. It's not that this whole is made it into four parts. Okay? So, and finally, by doing that, Yajna Karma is established. Chaturhotra Karma is established. So, then after removing out, everything is finished in this? No, not finished. Getting sleepy, everyone? Sleep, huh? Feeling sleepy? Next class, they will sleep. Okay, Adhvaryam Karma. So, so, but at least this much you understood, na, Prabhu? Adhvaryam Karma means these are the, it is comprised of, or it is done by the some specific mantras which are coming from the Yajurveda and chanted by the Adhvaryu. So that details actually, when you see in the Yajna, then you'll understand how it is. Some very rarely in South India you can see this kind of Yajna, full Yajna. Very rarely we get opportunity to see. I have one friend actually, he's expert in all this. Maybe sometime we'll... He's also, you know. Okay. No, this is very complex. It is having a lot of details in this. What is the different spoons we use, names, and also system, procedure, prakriti, vikriti. Big complex process this is. Karma, na, actually, that's why. Bhakti is very simple, actually. Chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Ram. Oh. Very enthusiastic. Okay, so like this Yajurveda, so is divided. That means we took out four parts. Then after that, remaining is there. In this, something is remaining. That is, what is that? Akhyanaihi, upakhyanaihi, gathabihi, vijottamaha, vijasattamaha, purana samhitam chakre, puranartha visharadaha. The expert of the puranas. Who is that? The expert of the knower of the purana, meanings of the Vedas and puranas. That is Vedavyas. Vedavyas only doing this work. Okay? Who is doing like this dividing? Vedavyas. And after taking out those mantras, something is remaining in this. That means, what are those? Akhyana. Akhyana means stories. Upakhyana means stories in the stories. Gatha means history. So all these he comprised as one another book. That book name is Puranam, Purana Samhita. That is Purana Samhita. Today we are going to hear Brahma Samhita. Brahma Samhita, Sloka. In the first and third chapter, Sloka number 42, 40, 41. Bhagavatam is known as? So Pranam Brahma Samhita. So this, by using these stories, sub stories and the various histories, so once again Purana is comprised, Purana is compiled, that is known as. So now you can see this Purana, of course Samhita means everything is coming, Purana Itihasa consider as a one set. So this is now fifth one or not? Is it coming inside to this? No. So this is establishing what? Fifth Veda. Puranas are fifth Veda. Is established or not? No, it is from the Vayupurana. Chandogya Upanishad is also there. Yeah. So after doing the Purana Samhita, so Purana Samhita, after doing this, whatever are remaining, those are kept back in the Yajurveda only. Okay, you understood? Whatever are remaining, after taking out the Puranas also, whatever are remaining, those are kept back in the Yajurveda only. Okay, clear? Udari rahi jayega. Prabhu? Is it visible or not? Board, online students? Visible only, na? Prabhu?
Hare Krishna. Puranas are only telling that these are the fifth Purana, right?
Purana only tell. Who will tell then? Because they are Swayam Prakasha. Purana, Itihasa, or Veda, they will tell about themselves, na? If someone is telling, then they are superior to this. All Vedas, that means Purana, Itihasas, four Vedas, everything is known as Vedas. Should tell about them. Either Shruti or the Purana. So even Chandogya Upanishad also is telling. Of course, that is also Veda. Why Purana is also Veda or not? Yeah. And who will establish Veda? Who will establish Veda? Veda itself will establish. No, Veda will say. If God only will say the God, then everyone will say God. Poor objection. Poor bhakshis are very much, nowadays poor bhakshis are increasing. Yachishtam tu, yachishtam means whatever is remaining, tu yajurvede iti sastrartha niranayaha, that is kept back in Yajurveda only. Clear this much? Prabhu? Puranartha Vishardaha. Puranartha Vishardaha is Vasudev. Who knows who is expert in the meanings of the Purana. Okay, next. Where is this? Brahma yajnadhyene cha viniyogo drishyate amisham yad brahmanani itihasa puranani iti saupi na avedatve sambhavati. What is this meaning? In the performance of the Brahma yajna, the inclusion of the Purana itihasas in as stated by yad brahmana itihasa puranani. So this is not possible without purana itihasa having vedatvam. Brahma yajna means what? No. Oh, you are all intelligent actually. Always the application actually. Very quickly applying. Good. Yajna means not that. It is a karma done by Brahma. No. Brahma yajna means daily sacrifice. Daily we recite this Vedas, Puranas. So that is known as Brahma Yajna. Like the various yajnas are there, na, various sacrifices. For Brahmachari, these Grihasthas, this in the Bhagavad Gita also we see. Yes or no? Yeah. Brahma Yajna means daily chanting Vedas. Brahma means what? So chanting the Vedas. Actually, this is Brahma Yajna means daily performing ritual. So that reciting the Vedas is a daily work, na? So Brahma Yajna is Nitya Karma actually. It is a Nitya Karma, daily prescribed duty. So reciting the Vedas. There, Puranas also included in that. So without including the Puranas, that means Puranas also they included means as a Brahma Yajna. In Brahma Yajna, Puranas are also included means Puranas also should be Veda. Otherwise, how they are included in the Brahma Yajna? Yes or no? Understood? A regular or daily reciting of Vedas is known as Brahma Yajna. So, in that, Puranas are also included. That means, if the Puranas and Itihasas are not the Veda, then how can they included in the, how can they are included in, how can be included in, how can they be included in Vedas? Oh, sorry, Brahma Yajna. So this is the point. Ataha yadaha bhagavan matsi. That's why, so Bhagavan in the Matsya Purana is saying, Kale nagrahanam matva puranasyadi jottama vyasa rupamaham krutva samharami yuge yuge. So what he is doing? Bhagavan Matsya. Matsya Purana, in the Lord, Lord is saying, what he is saying? Kalena agrahanam matva. As time is increasing, people not accepting the Purana itihasas. So considering this, so he is taking the form of Vyasa, and after that what? He is collecting back all the Puranas. He is collating. That means samharami means collecting or the collating. Bringing at one place. Yuge. In every yuga, he will do like that. Samharami means bringing together, collecting. Hrudatu. Samharanam means, samharanam we may think killing, but it is not that. It is having many meanings. Samharami means bringing together. Sam means collecting. Purva siddhameva puranam sukha sangrahanaya sankalayami iti tatra ardaha. Jiva Goswami himself is saying, samharami means sankalayami. Meaning is sankalayami. Sankalanam means samkalanam vyavakalanam. You know na? Sankalanam means adding. Vyavakalanam means subtracting. Telugu students, they know that. Sankalanam vyavakalanam. 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. It is what? Sankalanam. 4 minus 2 is equal to 2. It is Vyavakalanam. So Vyasdev is collecting all together. He is adding and making as one. Venu means it's properly he is arranging, bringing. So, Purva Siddhameva Puranam. That means it is already existing. Vyasadeva is not making, he is not writing newly any Purana. He is collecting only, just. Tadanantaram hi uktam. After that it is said. In that Matsya Purana it is said. Chaturlaksha pramanena dvapare sada. Tadashtadashadhakritva bhurlokesmin prabhashyate. Adhyapyamartya lokes loketu satakoti pravistaram. Tadarthotra chaturlakshaha sankshepena niveshitaha. What Bhagavan is saying, what he is saying? He is saying, Chatur Laksha Pramanena Dvapare Dvapare Sada Tad Ashtadasada Krutva Bhurloke Prabhashyate. So, only 4 lakhs verses are he is collecting, and he is dividing that 4 lakh into 18 parts, and he is giving to the Bhulokavasis. Bhurloke Esmin Prabhashyate. Adhyapi amartya loke, even now also, in the heavenly planet, non-mortal planet, that means heavenly planets. So, tu satakoti pravistaram. How many slokas are there in that Puranas? 100 crores ujjwal. 100 crores. Tadarthotra, tadardaha, tadardaha, that means their essence. Ardha means you should take their essence. Chaturlakshaha sankshepena atra niveshitaha. Atra means bhurloke. Bhurloke niveshitaha. Okay. One important sentence is there. Okay. This is only one line I will take. Atra tu yat sishtam tu yajurvede ityuktatva tasya abidheya bhagas chatur lakshatu atra marchaloke sankshepena sara sangrihena niveshta natu rachanantarena. So, a very important point you have to here understand. So, what is that? What he is saying in the Matsya Purana, what he said? 100 crores. 100 crores. 100 crores of the verse, 100 crores. 100 crores of verses are there. So this is where it is. It is in the Amartya Loka. That means in the heavenly planets. But now in this our planet, 4 lakhs. That means one may think that these 4 lakhs, 4 lakhs means they may think they are the summary of these 100 crores means they might have Vyasadeva. Read everything, 100 crores, and summary he wrote. It is like, looks like that. But here, what here, Jiva Goswami is clarifying here, Abhidheya Bhagaha. Baldev Devotion saying, Abhidheya Bhagaha means Sara Sangraha, Sara Rupaha. That means, in this 100 crores, whatever the summarized stories are there, that means summaries, in the summary points, those are directly taken. Vyasadeva didn't write separately. In the 100 crores slokas, whichever are the summary type slokas are there, those he collected and he made the 4 lakhs. That means Puranas are not manufactured by anyone. So that's why many people, they say that 100 crores are there and 4 lakhs are here. Means this is a Sara of that 100 crores means definitely someone might have written. They may think like that. But it is not written. Na rachanantarena. It is not again writing. It is as it is. That means from there only it is taken. So then what he did about remaining 100 crores, if you remove the, if you subtract 4 lakhs, then how many are there? 99 crores. 96 lakhs. So those things what he did? Yet he kept back. In what we read previously, Vyasadeva compiled the Purana Samhita. Remember na that Vayu Purana statement. In the Vayupurana statement, this is the connection actually. Vayupurana statement, what is saying? After compiling Purana Samhita, whatever are remaining, those are kept back. Said, na? That means 4 lakhs are removed and remaining 99 crores, 96 lakhs are kept back only. Okay, done class. Done for today.
Oh, it is said kept back means already book, already there. This book form mein jo diya hai, wo alag se bana ke diya. Just 4 bataya yahan pe na, yajurved, samved.
Aap connection connect ho, disconnect ho gaye. You are in the connection or not? Yajurveda?
Yes.
This?
Yes.
4?
Yes.
Then after that? So, Purana Itihas are compiled. How many are there these? For Vyasadeva, how many he did for us?
4 lakh.
Four, one, okay. Originally, how many?
100 crore.
And remaining, what he did? Is there only? Yachishtam to Yajurvede. Yachishtam to Yajurvede.
That means it is in book form, Yajurveda, what you say, just Brahma Loka. There's 100 crores is there.
This is not 100 crores.
No, that is...
It is even more.
It is more.
Yeah. It is hundreds and thousands and more than 100 crores this is. In this, only 100 crores are the Puranas.
Yes, 100 crore Puranas.
Yeah.
So...
Oh, in that only 4 lakhs he took.
Took in the sense how to understand. Took means...
Essence.
He made a book. Yeah, like that he just like... It took
that means when he went to his meditation,
yeah,
all the mantras are okay. So that means they are appearing in front of him.
Okay,
take this.
Then and he for us
remaining, he left there only.
Yes, that understood.
Yeah,
and then it manifested in the form of book, like the Vyasadeva.
And then after that, Ganapati is writing, Ganesh, he's writing for us.
Yeah. So for Martha Loka, available is this 4 and this 4 lakh.
For Martha Loka, only 4 lakh Purana Samhita and these Vedas, 4
this,
Vedas.
This is more than outside 4 lakh, yeah? These 4 Vedas?
These are 4 Vedas out of 4.
Out of 4. So yeah. This total is available.
These 4 lakhs we have Skanda Purana 80,000.
It's there, yeah.
And Bhagavatam is 18,000. And like this, if you go, it's almost all 4 lakhs. This 18 Puranas fully, that means 4 lakhs.
And Vedas extra.
And Vedas are, those are 4 are other.
And this Yajurveda is not in this world, this Prithvi.
No, this is original.
This is not available.
Original copy this is.
It's in Brahma Loka.
It is in the eternal, everywhere it is there.
So Brahma Loka?
It's already is rotating, is all pervading actually. In sound form it is there. If you want to get it, that you should you do the tapasya and it will enter into you.
Encyclopedia.
Yes. In every manvantara ending, is almost all disappearing. So in the next starting of manvantara, these saptarshis, they will be meditating, doing tapasya, and all those will once again enter. And those will be propagated. But when Kali Yuga will come, before Kali Yuga, Vyasadeva once again he will do 4 parts. Prabhuji ko ek assistant chahiye jo mic bolenge.
Hare Krishna. Vedas are personified person, na?
Yes, that is also. Like the earth is also is having the Adi Bhautika,
yeah.
And there is also one Adi Deva.
Yes.
There is a deity for that. Like that, everything. Vikas Dubey Prabhu.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Yes, Prabhu.
Prabhu, one thing I always struggle, and it will be very helpful if you can explain me.
Yes, Prabhu.
That why Prabhu karma is called as yajna or sacrifice, you know. So
yeah.
I don't understand how karma is yajna or sacrifice. Especially like when I read English definition, it says any possessions which you are offering is called as a sacrifice, or they give example like a goat is sacrificed by Vedas, you know, they say animal is sacrificed. So that is not our position at all. So what we are sacrificing, or say, so that's a difficulty for me to understand, how to understand why it is called karma is a sacrifice or yajna. How is that
So, karma means duty. So, these duties are the how to explain this is. So, everyone knows actually karma means yagya. Karma samudho. So yagna karma. Yeah. Yagya is also one karma. Because here karmakanda, that's by section it changes Prabhu. Yagya, which is performed for the having the any material results, and then that is known as karma. So that's why here yagya is known as karma, not in every places. In the karmakanda we take yagya as karma.
Oh, Prabhu, like if we are doing it for fruitive activities, why it is called sacrifice then?
It is sacrifice because it is done, originally it should be done for the satisfaction of Krishna only. But because people are not understanding that, they are expecting result from that. So that is also giving that. This particular karma is... Everything is for what? Every activity in this whole universe is meant for the satisfying the Lord, Supreme Lord. But because of the lack of that understanding, so one may expect the result for his own satisfaction. Even sacrifice is also there, yagya is there, to satisfy Vishnu only. Like that's why if you see in the Rajasvi Yaga, so when Rajasvi Yaga is done, so at that time also, our devotees, when they did this karma, yagya means karma, this Vedic sacrifice, they didn't expect any result. They did for the satisfaction of the Lord. That means when they say Indraya Swaha, this is a karma only. That means this yagya, when they are performing that one mantra came, Indraya Swaha. So a common person, how he think Indraya Swaha means I am giving this oblation to the Indra. But when devotee, he does this yagya, then what he will think? So he'll be thinking that this is Indra is the part of the limbs of the Lord, or otherwise vibhuti of the Lord only. That means I am giving to this oblation, this oblation for the Lord only. It is reaching to the Lord only. So like this, but they so will
can
be.
Can I infer then that any activity which is done for fruitive results
is karma?
Is not sacrifice. It's not yagna.
So it is karma, but here yagya is also used as karma.
But then if it is not done for the Lord, then it is not yagna or sacrifice, right, Prabhu?
But it is also having that kind of notation, Prabhu. So that means you can take yagya as, that means rudi artha. Rudi artha means is a fixed artha. In the karma kanda, yagya means karma. It's a rudi. By place, it will change.
So it is not absolutely yagna or sacrifice all the time. By context, we are changing it.
Yeah, yeah. Yagya is not necessary that all the time it should be karma. Yes.
Because Prabhu, when we hear or read also in the like ancient times, they say that always yagnas were performed for certain results. For example, like Lord Dashratha did. Understand that, Prabhu, because that was a fruitive activity, right? To get something.
Yeah. All the activities are, especially if you see in the whole universe, everything, all the system, if you see entire Vedic duties, Vedic rituals, whatever is there, everything is concluded in the Lord only. Vasudeva para Vedaha, Vasudeva para Makaha. Makaha means all the sacrifices are all for the Vasudeva only. Vasudeva Paramakaha. So everything is for the Lord, but what is happening now? So, but because of the lack of consciousness, so they are using that for their own gratification. Then that is known as karma. If you do sacrifice, which is there, but for the satisfaction of the Lord, then that is a perfection actually. That is the perfect purport of that statement.
Okay, Prabhu, thanks.
Maaseva Prabhu, we have another class. Okay. Okay, tell me quickly.
Yeah. Prabhuji, like you said that generally we know that Vyasadeva has written 4 lakh verses. But 4 lakh you are saying Puranas only. Purana and Itihasa. So what about Vedas? Vedas will be 4 lakh plus or?
These.
4 lakh you said part of Puranas and Itihasa. No?
4 lakh are the only Puranas.
And generally we know that Vedavyasa has written 4 lakh verses. Is that correct?
No, no. That only Puranas are 4 lakhs. Vedas are so many verses are there. Millions of, not billion, but so many thousands. No, like, of, 4 lakh is for only Puranas.
Okay. Vedas, we don't know like how many verses.
They are in more. This planet. Vedas, how many are given and how many are kept back? That I don't know. Okay. But Puranas, out of 100 crores, 4 lakhs are taken and given to us. And okay, maybe okay. Even in this case also, not giving the complete Veda for the Kali Yuga. So he took from that also something and he kept back in once again in that Yajurveda. That is maybe that, I don't know actually. But we are especially interested in Purana Itihasa. So we are going with that.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much, Srila Prabhupada ki jai.